Well, you may remember a while back when we asked if any of you would like a makeover for a room in your home using what you already have. Well, Judy Bobeck did, and she wrote us saying, I would love to have someone to come to my house and do a room makeover on my great room. I moved into this great house a year ago, and I just love it. I have no interior design skills on how to arrange a room to look its best. It is a big room, and I want to make it look beautiful when people enter my home. Please, 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 please help me. Well, help arrived. We sent Q104's Jen Tuohy along with redesigner Kim Ausbury, owner of Staged and Styled, to help Judy out. Take a look.
Oh my goodness, Robin, this is such an exciting day. Here we are at Judy's house. We're gonna give her a complete room makeover. Judy, thanks for welcoming us into your home today.
Oh, you're welcome.
Now, are we standing in the room that you wanna have redone?
Yes, we are.
What's the problem? It looks pretty good to me.
I love this room, but I want it to be more conducive to when people come over, it seems too bunched together because that area over there is open because they used it as a dining area.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I see what you're saying. That space is kind of
open. Yeah, so I just have like junk stuff there right now.
And maybe this area over here, we want to try and make a little cozier, put stuff closer together. Well, here's what we're going to do. We're going to bring in a redesigner to redesign this room today. Is that
exciting? Okay, that's exciting.
All right, let's do it. Okay, you're going to want to pay attention to this part because we brought in the pros. I'm here with Kim from Staged and Styled. Now, Kim, you've already sat down with Judy and kind of went over what she wants to do in this room.
That's right.
All right, let's see what you guys talked about.
Well, we talked about that she loves the size of the room and she loves the furniture, but the arrangement is just not really working for her.
Okay.
When she has family and friends over, it's just a little too spaced out. And then over in this corner, we've got an area that just, you know, doesn't really have a purpose.
So what are you going to do to kind of solve her problem? You think you can fix it?
I think we can.
Okay,
we're going to rearrange some furniture. We shopped her house, and I have my eye on a couple pieces in other rooms that I'm going to pull in. And also give this area over here a purpose that'll make her really happy.
Now, how'd you determine this? This questionnaire, like, give us a couple of questions that you asked her to kind of decide.
Right. With all my clients, I send them a client questionnaire. And one of them is, what are the primary functions of the room we are focusing on? And she put that this is her living room, and they do entertaining with family. And she does not want a TV in here, which is kind of cool because usually all of our furniture focuses around the TV.
Oh,
so this
okay.
will be fun. We'll have to figure out what the focal point is, which you'll have to stay tuned for that, and rearrange the furniture around that.
I love it. You're really kind of getting inside her head and
exactly.
knowing exactly what she wants.
Exactly.
Okay, I think it's time to get to work.
Let's get to work.
All right, let's do it.
The next phase of the process is to actually shop the home. So Judy and I are standing here in her family room, and I have my eye on a couple really great pieces for her living room. I have my eye on these candlesticks down here, which I think will be a really nice asset. I also wanted to take this piece up here, but Judy said no, she wanted me to leave it there. So I will honor the homeowner and leave it right where it is. But I also would like to take this lamp into the living room for some extra lighting, and I think that'll serve a really great purpose. Okay, Judy, I just spied a rug, and I think this is just about the right size we're going to need in your living room. Would
That's
it be
fine.
All right if we use this one?
Yes, you can use that one.
Okay, thanks. Let's go into the next room. Okay, so here's the next bedroom. Oh, Judy, what about that mirror? Tell me a little bit about that.
I just purchased that, and I want it hung somewhere in that room, but
okay.
wherever you feel is being good.
Okay, great. I think we might be able to utilize that. Really good piece. Okay, Judy, why don't you lead the way down the hall? Oh, I see pictures. Tell me about these pictures. Where did you find them?
I purchased these pictures when I was on a bus tour in New York.
Oh, okay. Do they have any special meaning to you, or are they...
No, but I like them here.
Okay, I like them here. So does that mean I can or cannot use them?
Cannot.
Oh, cannot. Okay. Okay, Judy, here we are in your master bedroom, and it looks like it's set up really great. I am spying just a few accessories, but for the most part, I think everything's pretty set in here.
It
Do you
is.
Agree?
Mm-hmm. And if you can use anything in here, that'd be fine.
Okay. I love that attitude.
Okay.
So far, it's great. We have an empty space, and what needs to come back in are the big pieces once we get everything cleared out. So. Going good. OK, Okay, guys, you gotta go now. I have to get to work. So check back in a few hours and you'll see a brand new room. See ya.
All right, it's time now to see how our room redesigner did. Now, here's a reminder of what the room looked like before the redo. And now let's check in with Q104's Jen Tuohy and redesigner Kim Ausbury as they reveal the room's new look to the owners, Judy and Carl.
Okay, so it's been about 3 hours, and I think they're coming back now. Okay. Let's go let them in.
All right.
Judy.
Hi. Hi, Carl. Come on in. There's been a lot of work done in your house. Are you ready to see it?
I am.
Okay. Are you ready? Are you excited?
Nervous.
Oh, yeah, all
nervous.
Right. Let's go on in. Come on. For the big reveal.
Oh, my gosh.
Can you believe this is your house?
No.
Wow.
I love that over there.
Amazing. You're simply
talk to us about exactly what you did to try and bring
sure.
this room together.
Sure. Well, earlier today, when I sat down with Judy, we talked about how this room was so big and she loved that, but yet it didn't feel cozy to her. And so she wanted a space where she could entertain people. And so what I did over on this side of the room is created a more cozy, intimate, warm, inviting space for all of her friends to come and sit down and talk with her.
And you did that just by angling the furniture.
Exactly.
Right?
And as I mentioned earlier today, there's not a TV in this room. So usually in most living rooms, that's the focal point. But Judy had mentioned that her favorite part of the room were the windows. So we just angled the sofa to face out towards the view, which worked out really well.
And enjoy the view outside. Now, I remember this side of the room was really kind of open. There wasn't anything here.
Right.
Did you buy this?
No, what was so fun is we found this in their living room. And so we placed it here. It worked really, really well. And also, I was able to create a seating area for Judy in this corner of the room where there was really nothing much going on. It didn't really have a purpose. So we created a seating area for her to talk on the phone, and I think she likes it.
And what about on the walls, too? Were these things hanging on the walls before? You moved some of that stuff around, too?
Yes, I did. And also, Judy was holding out on me. I found
she
those.
Was.
Yes.
Judy, how dare
Judy,
you?
Judy, I found those crosses in a closet after she had left, and she gave me permission, obviously, to go through her closet, but exactly, and then I also created this little vignette of small pictures over here, but when you group them together, it looks like a larger piece of art, so it works
sure
much
does.
Better.
And it works really well together. And then you put some accessories on the table here, I
exactly.
see.
Exactly, this tray right here was actually a mirror that she had hanging over this shelf on this wall, and so I just took it down and created a tray out of it to give her a little bit different look, because when we talked earlier in the day, she had shown me a picture of a shelf with stacked pictures and photos on it that she really, really liked, so I was able to recreate that for her.
How creative is that? Taking a mirror off the wall and making it a tray on the table.
I like this sitting area here because before it was like everybody was, those other two chairs were here, the couch was way over there. And a couple of times when I had company over, we moved the two chairs closer.
Hey, now you don't have to rearrange.
No, we just have it like this.
It's perfect.
And I love the baker's rack over there like that.
We're going to have to put a bird feeder outside of your window so you can see the birds fly up while you sit here and enjoy the view.
I have one in the backyard. It can go up front.
Yeah. See, we can rearrange the outside too.
Okay.
The room looks beautiful. It's great. I never expected this. I expected when we left, I said, you know what they're going to do? They're going to take the couch off the wall, put it over here, put the two chairs over there. I was just completely amazed when I walked in here.
Kim, you really did some amazing work in this room today. People watching at home that maybe want to make some changes in their own place, what would you suggest they do?
Well, I would say one tip, if they have a room just like Judy's, which is a rectangular in shape, kind of a bowling alley type room, I would say one thing not to do is place your sofa with the length of the room, because that'll just make the room appear more elongated, and that is something that you don't want to do. So if they place it on an angle, it gives the room a whole new feel.
And I think they should go shopping in their own house.
Absolutely.
I'm going to do that.
Absolutely. If you have a chair in your master bedroom, pull it out and put it in your living room. Or if you have a chair in your living room, go put it in your master bedroom. You never know what it'll look like.
Some really great suggestions of today on how to make changes in your own home.
great. And Judy agrees. Here's what she wrote to us after the room was redone. I want to thank everyone again for such a great time when my redesign was being shot. We all laughed. Everyone was great. And even my husband had a nice time. I love my room and have just sat in it looking around. Well, Judy, we're glad you're happy. Sorry you don't have a TV in there because you're probably missing That's Life. But for those who want more information about our redesign, our redesigner, Kim Ausbury, we will have that on our website.